click the bell icon to get latest videos from Equida.
Hello friends, in case of convection analysis, the analysis of fluid dynamics is quite important. Velocity boundary layer and thermal boundary layer is one of the two analyses which are essential for the convection. Let us understand the thermal boundary layer concept. For that, we have kept a plate whose temperature is, let's say, surface temperature, let's say TS, and we will assume that TS is greater than T infinity, where T infinity is nothing but the temperature of the fluid which is flowing over a plate. If this is the case, then what will happen? Obviously, the heat will flow from the plate to the fluid, and in that process, this point, this is the leading point where the temperature of the fluid, temperature of the molecule of the fluid is same as the temperature of the surface. And then as we travel in x direction, the temperature will start varying. If the value of TS can be greater than T infinity, or the TS can be less than T infinity. If the TS is greater than T infinity, the heat flow will travel in upward direction, or else the heat flow will travel in downward direction. Now in this case, if you assume that the T infinity is higher than the TS, obviously what will happen? The temperature in the upward direction will keep on increasing. See, as there is a temperature gradient that will come into picture because of this. You can imagine that this layer is having some temperature TS, and as we move up in the direction of or perpendicular to the direction of the flow, the molecule temperature will keep on increasing. And then this will cause what they call as the temperature gradient, that is dT by dy in the y direction. Now, there will be a distance from the plate where, let us call the distance is, let's say, delta T. Now, they call this delta T as thermal boundary layer thickness. This is thermal boundary layer thickness. Now, this delta T can be said as the thickness where the temperature difference. So let's say the temperature is T, the temperature of the fluid in this region is T. So in that case, the T minus T infinity upon TS minus T infinity is almost 0.99 that of the T infinity itself. If that is the case, or in other word, the temperature reaches almost equal to the temperature of the free stream. If that is the case, then the length is called as the thermal boundary layer. One more thing that one need to talk about is the laminar, the transition and the turbulent layer. The profile of the thermal boundary layer will vary in case of a laminar, transition and turbulent layer. In other case, if the value of TS is greater than the T infinity, then the profile will look something like this. Obviously, the temperature will keep on decreasing. Now, this is your delta T, and these are your free stream temperature T infinity. And the surface temperature is, let's say, TS. So this will again obviously cause the temperature gradient. So what we have seen here, that there is a distinct region that exists due to the temperature gradient. Now this distinct region they call as the thermal boundary layer. Now this is done for the simplification of the analysis. What you can make out is Because of this layer, there are two regions that are formed over the plate. At one region, there exists the dt by dx, and apart from this region, there is no dt by dx. The temperature gradient is almost constant above this layer. So the dt by dx does not exist in this region. Now, because of this, we can only consider the heat transfer by conduction in this region. And we can easily go for the heat transfer by convection above this region. Now, this is very much analogous to the velocity boundary layer. Now, in case of a velocity boundary layer, the boundary layer itself exists because of the velocity gradient. See, the velocity gradient is what causes the velocity boundary layer, and again, this is my delta V. So, this is the velocity boundary layer thickness, and this is the thermal boundary layer thickness. Now, the thermal boundary layer thickness depends on the dT by dx. Velocity boundary layer thickness depends on the du by dx. Now, what connects these two, or what is the significance of the thermal boundary layer and the velocity boundary layer? Now, the connection between these two, or the significance of these two, can be said with the help of Prandtl number. Now, what is Prandtl number? The Prandtl number is nothing but the momentum diffusivity, they call it, by the kinematic viscosity, and the thermal diffusivity. So, momentum diffusivity, so you can change it. The momentum diffusivity can be given as mu, and the thermal diffusivity can be given as alpha. So, Prandtl number is nothing but the ratio of momentum diffusivity to thermal diffusivity. Kinematic viscosity talks about the momentum diffusivity, and alpha talks about the thermal diffusivity. Means how the momentum is transferred and how the thermal energy is transferred. Now, this Prandtl number basically relates between the velocity boundary layer and then the thermal boundary layer. If the Prandtl number is 1, then we can say that this thermal boundary layer is same as the velocity boundary layer. If the Prandtl number is more than 1, if it is more than 1, means the momentum diffusivity is higher as compared to the thermal diffusivity. Then in that case, we can say that the delta T is lower than the delta V. If it is less than 1, then the thermal diffusivity is higher, then obviously the delta T will be more than the delta V. See, there are quite a few examples where the Prandtl number is almost 1. And the Prandtl number is more than 1 only when the momentum diffusivity is higher. Now, the momentum diffusivity is higher only when the viscosity is lower. So, the examples can be set in this case are, see, delta T is more than delta V. This is only a case where the viscosity is lower, such as various liquids and gases. So, these are the examples where the viscosity is lower. There we can say that the Prandtl number is less than 1. So, for example, the Prandtl number of water is almost 0.7. And then for the grease or oil, where the viscosity is quite high, we can say that the Prandtl number is more than 1. So, there the delta V is higher as compared to the delta T. Now, what we have done with the help of this thermal boundary layer is that we have classified the given region between the two regions, one region where the delta T exists and the other region where the delta T does not exist. Now, that is it in this topic. In this topic, we have discussed about the thermal boundary layer thickness and its significance and its analogy with respect to the velocity boundary thickness. Thank you for watching this video. Please stay tuned with Ikeda and subscribe to Ikeda. Thank you.